Hi, and welcome to Agronomy CDEID. So today we're going to be going over insects and the insect ID for the contest. Now, before we dive into the actual insects and the actual identification and what is what and who is who, we're going to go into a little bit of background and entomology. Now, the rest of this video is all background, so if you just hate this, don't think this will help you at all, then skip it, go to the next video. But I did want to go into some of this background because I personally think that this would help you remember a lot more easily than just going through things. So a little bit of background, especially into taxonomy, how we organize living things. We know that insects are animals. They are in the kingdom Animalia. If you didn't, now you do. Congratulations. Now, if you've taken companion animal bio, you know that our the phylum level that we usually work with is Chordata. Now, that's all animals that have a backbone, but here we're working in the phylum Arthropoda, which means joint-legged, which means that all of these animals in this phylum are going to have an exoskeleton with a lot of joints on their legs. Now, underneath phylum, we do have class Insecta, which is all the insects. Pretty straightforward, good to know. And then under that, we have 33 different orders of insects. Now, here we're going to be focusing on three, and there are three others, which means y'all got lucky, and there are 27 you don't have to know. Now, as we go through here, I'll talk about, if this insect is actually its own species or if it's a group of insects. But a lot of these insects are going to be down to the family and to the genus levels, not just the species level. And we'll talk about those and kind of how they lay out there. But the three orders that we're going to focus on are the beetles, the moths, and the true bugs, which we'll talk about that. Now, when you talk about insects just in general, there are a couple of things that all of these animals have in common. Number one, they have three body sections. So they are going to have a head, a distinct thorax, and a distinct abdomen. They're going to have three pairs of legs. So if you know how to math, then that's six total. They're going to have two pairs of wings in general. And if you know how to math there, that means four wings, two on each side. And then finally, they're going to have one pair of antennae. And this is going to be two antennae at the top of the head. Now, depending on the insect, is dependent on how big and showy those antennae are. Now, some insects, like the dragonfly, are going to have very tiny aristae antenna, where, like here in the wasp, we have larger club-like antenna. All of these insects are going to have some type of mouth parts. There are some insects out there that don't have mouth parts. If you're interested in those, ask me about them later. They are all going to have some type of mouth parts, and all closely related insects are going to have similar mouth parts. And so we'll talk about that as we go through. But to recap, three body parts, three pairs of or six legs, two pairs or four wings, and one pair or two antennae. Now, when we talk about insects and how they grow up, this is their life cycle, or otherwise known as their metamorphosis, how they change over time, how they morph. Now, there are actually four types of metamorphosis in the insect world, but we're going to be focusing on two here, complete and incomplete. Now, the one that you probably know a lot about of is complete. Now, this is where the immature insect looks completely different from the adult. This will always include some sort of cocoon or pupa stage. And in this type of metamorphosis, only the adults are going to have wings. So only the adults are going to fly. Now, this goes back to your elementary example of egg, caterpillar, cocoon, butterfly, as you can see right here. Now, our other type of metamorphosis that some of these insects may have is going to be incomplete metamorphosis. So an immature is just going to look like an incomplete adult. It's going to look very similar. However, it's going to be smaller, wingless, and probably missing a few other characteristics. Now, again, here, only the adults have wings. You can see here in the nymphal stages that this grasshopper is getting gradually bigger. And in this teenage stage, you kind of see winglets here, but only the adult is going to have true full wings where it can actually fly. And so you can see here, egg, nymph, adult. Now that wraps up our first video. Join me for the rest of the videos and we'll get trucking along.